Every component and device that you'll install in an electrical system will have its own type of connection, and the best attachment or terminal to use for each device is exactly what we're going to cover here in lesson number one of this wire terminals playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, before we get started, I put some important information about this academy, some additional resources, and some prerequisite information related to this video down in the pinned comment below. So be sure to scroll down and check it out. And lastly, there are thousands of types of wire connectors on the market, but we're not going to cover all of them. Instead, we're just going to cover the most popular ones that you're actually likely to find in most typical installations like we talk about here on this channel. I'm going to break these down into the format of type of component connection, what type of wire terminal goes on it, and some examples of related components. Let's get started. Stud terminal for wire sizes greater than 8 gauge. If a component has a stud that just looks like the threaded part of a bolt, or a bolt that threads into the component itself, and the component requires 8 gauge or larger wire, you're going to be using a wire lug to make the connection. Now, to choose the proper wire lug, you need two things. You need to know the wire size and the stud size. Now, wire lugs are going to be classified by those two measurements. For example, a 4-aught by 5/16 inch wire lug will accept 4-aught wire, and the hole in the lug will fit onto a 5/16 inch stud. Now, wire lugs are most commonly sized for wires from 8 gauge up to 4-aught, as well as for stud sizes from a number 8 screw up to a 1/2 inch stud, with 1/4 inch, 5/16 inch, and 3/8 inch being the most common. Some examples of components that require wire lugs will be the positive and negative terminals of a Victron Multiplus inverter charger, the positive and negative terminals of the Blue Sea safety hub, all of the terminals of the Victron Lynx distributor, and the Tiger XPED UFO 200. Wire lugs come in tinned and untinned versions. Now, the untinned are simply pure copper, and the tinned versions are coated in a thin layer of tin coating that helps prevent corrosion in corrosive atmospheres, like on a boat subject to salty sea air. Now, there are also mechanical lugs with a set screw that holds the wire in place instead of being crimped, and these should basically only be used in residential breaker boxes, for service entries, and for not much of anything else. These should not be used in any system that moves like a boat or RV. Stud terminals for wire sizes less than 8 gauge. Now, if a component has a stud that just looks like the threaded part of a bolt, or a screw that threads into the component itself and requires 8 gauge or smaller, you're going to be using a ring terminal like this to make the connection. Ring terminals are basically just smaller and thinner wire lugs for generally smaller wires. To choose the proper ring terminal, you need two things. Just like wire lugs, you need to know the wire size going into the terminal, as well as the stud size that the terminal is going to fit onto. Now, ring terminals are going to be classified by those two measurements. For example, a 14 to 16 gauge by number 10 ring terminal will accept 14 to 16 gauge wire, and the hole in the terminal will fit onto a number 10 stud or screw. Now, ring terminals are most commonly sized for wires from 20 gauge all the way up to 6 gauge, as well as for stud sizes from a number 6 screw up to a 1/2 inch stud, with basically every size in between being fairly common depending on the device it's connecting to. Some examples of devices needing ring terminals is the Blue Sea safety hub, the Garmin power switch, or the Tiger XBed UFO 200. There are several common variations of ring terminals. We've got an insulated ring terminal that has a nylon insulator around the crimp barrel of the ring terminal that decreases the amount of conductive material exposed. We also have uninsulated ring terminals, and they have no insulation, and these would typically get a little piece of heat shrink applied right over the crimp connection. I don't have any on hand because I don't typically use them. And my favorite are heat shrink ring terminals that have some pre-attached heat shrink just right onto the crimp connection that are activated with a heat gun after the ring terminal has been crimped onto the wire. Screw terminals. A screw terminal is a terminal that has an opening with a set screw on top where the wire just gets clamped in place when the screw is tightened. For components with these types of connections, we have three different options for terminals. We have ferrules, pin terminals, and just bare wire. Ferrules are just very thin sleeves of tin that more or less just go around the wire and then get crimped into place and simply holds all the wires together so that we can ensure that all the wires actually go into the terminal. Pin terminals serve a similar purpose, but instead of a sleeve, it crimps onto the end of the wire, and then there's a solid pin on the end that goes into the terminal. Now, these are good for terminals where fine stranded wire should be used, but a ferrule may be too big to fit into the terminal. Now, these aren't particularly common. And simply inserting stripped wire into a screw terminal is often acceptable. Just be sure to follow manufacturer's recommendations here, but more importantly, just make sure that all of the strands of wire actually go into the terminal. Otherwise, you'll have a loose connection and the terminal can melt. And just remember that ferrules are tools and they can make your project easier and have a bit of better workmanship, but also remember that they're not required. And if it makes your job harder rather than easier, you can usually omit them. Examples of components with screw terminals. We've got the Victron Smart Solar MPPT solar charge controller, the bus bars in the bottom of a 120 volt AC distribution panel, and the terminal of a 120 volt AC breaker. Now there are two different variations of ferrules, and those are insulated and non-insulated. The insulated ferrules have a nylon barrel around the base, and a non-insulated version does not. And we would typically put a bit of heat shrink on the back of the non-insulated ferrule to clean things up a bit and add a bit of extra protection and strain relief. Now, outside of that, both types of ferrules can take on several shapes, like hex-shaped for round screw terminals, square-shaped for square screw terminals, and trapezoid-shaped for square screw terminals. All of these different shapes are made by different types of crimpers, you know, depending on which one is used, and we'll talk about all of these in a future video. Wire-to-wire connections. Now, if you need to connect two wires together, there are several options available that we recommend. Anderson connectors, lever nuts, and butt splice crimp connectors. A common use for Anderson connectors would be the connection at the hitch between the tow vehicle and the RV for DC to DC charging. Lever nuts are gonna be for one or more wires, 10 gauge or smaller. Example here would be puck light connections. A butt splice crimp connection is going to be for joining two wires of similar size. For example, the Red Arc 25 amp BC DC charger. Some variations of these connectors, the Anderson connectors, they come in all kinds of different sizes, from really small 16 gauge connectors all the way up to 4-aught wire connectors. Butt splice connectors come in insulated versions, non-insulated versions, and my favorite, heat shrink versions that have a little bit of built-in heat shrink insulation. And lever nuts come in a few different sizes for 2 wires, 3 wires, and 5 wires, and there are versions for 10 gauge and smaller, as well as 12 gauge and smaller. PV connectors. Most solar panels on the market come standard with PV connectors, and these are also commonly known as MC4 connectors. And MC4 connectors is simply a brand of PV connectors, much like how Kleenex is a brand of tissue paper. They come in male and female versions for positive and negative connections, and they click and lock together to form a watertight seal. Now, a lot of people like to cut these off of their solar panels and solder them together, but these PV connectors are literally made for this application, so consider not doing that. Some variations of PV connectors are PV fuses for adding fuses to a solar array if needed, and PV branch circuit combiners, which combine solar panels or series strings of solar panels in parallel to make a larger solar panel array. Now, I know there are a lot of different wire terminals for various components in a mobile, marine, or off-grid electrical system, and I hope this video provided some clarity. Now, we're going to be referring to wire terminals throughout the rest of this academy, so be sure to bookmark this lesson for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher. Now, in the remainder of this wire terminal playlist, I'm actually going to teach you how to install these different terminals, starting with the absolute basics, which is learning how to cut wire from 22 gauge all the way up to 4-aught wire, which is up next. Click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there. Was that the right direction?